Good evening, everybody, and welcome to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships live from the beach in Wildwood. And what a glorious late July evening here at the Jersey Shore. And helping me with the call today, former chief of the Longport Beach Patrol, Dan Adams, and former lieutenant of the Ocean City Beach Patrol, Jack Brooks. And guys, Dan, we're at it again.
Billy, I can't say enough. It's great to be back. It's great to be out here. And what, just looking at this field of competitors out here tonight, we're ready for some racing. Let's go.
Jack Brooks, welcome to the broadcast. As a former lieutenant of the Ocean City Beach Patrol, it's great to see you. And we have a long history, you and I, but it's pretty cool that we're able to call the 53rd annual Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Race live from the beach in Wildwood.
It's unbelievable. I mean, you look at tonight, you look at Wildwood, you look at the show that they put on. It's going to be a fantastic evening of racing.
I want to thank Chief Steve Stocks and Captain Ed Snyder for facilitating this broadcast. Of course, the competitors are ready to go, Dan Adams. And you know, we've been doing this for a few years. And we're seeing a little bit of a changing of the guard, if you will, with the youth movement that I refer to on my locker room show every Saturday and Sunday. But we got a youth movement going on here with the Beach Patrol.
We do have a little youth movement. There is some change in the competitors, a lot younger competitors on a lot of the Beach Patrols. But you can't count out our guys that have been here and the guys that have been around for a long time. You know what? We look for a great night of racing. This is the first race of the Big Three, as we call them, you know, followed by the Margate Memorials and the South Jersey Championships. And this is one of a unique race where there's female and male competitors competing here tonight. And it's going to be a great night for racing, but we'll see how it plays out.
You know, Jack Brooks, it started on Friday, July 7th with the Mike McGrath Memorial Lifeguard Races from Longport and, of course, the Cape May Counties, which you were going to cover, but were canceled due to rain. But they were all individual races. They, you know, all the separate beach patrols, the Southern Beach Patrol stayed south. The Northern Beach Patrols were to the north. Today, like Dan just said, we're coming together for the Big Three, where all the beach patrols from Brigantine to Cape May Point are
absolutely
now involved.
You know, in the South Jersey Lifeguard Championship used to be the big one. 1963, this race was founded. The Dutch Hoffmans, named after their former captain, who served the Wildwood Beach Patrol in the 1930s, became captain in 37, and by 1962 he had passed. But what a record of improvements to the Wildwood Beach Patrol he had.
I got to tell you, I'm really excited to be here as we look at we're high above the beach here in Wildwood, and we got a little bit of a swell, Dan Adams.
We do have a swell, and it's going to come down to, you know, we talk about it all the time, rowing events especially, it's a start, it's a turn, it's a finish, and it's all going to be about how these guys finish on these waves tonight. There's a race winner out there for just about any crew tonight, and you can't count any crew out tonight. From Brigantine to Cape May, every crew has a shot tonight with this swell that's out here, and the opportunity is anyone's to go.
And as we're broadcasting live right now, the race is going to start officially at 6:30. But Jack, we got swimmers, we got doubles crews in the water, we got singles crews. They're getting ready, right? They're getting ready for this is going to be a fierce competition.
From the looks of things, we've got some swimmers that aren't even competitors in the water out here. I can't blame them on a 92-degree day for wanting to be in that beautiful ocean. I'm sure they'll clean them out by the time the race begins.
Let's look at some of the crews. Dan Adams, Beach Patrol from Brigantine, their doubles is Jack and Joe Seville. They're starting to move up in the conversation. Of course, you got the Blair brothers, Sean and Rick at Atlantic City, Bob Beckel and Hayden Swalwood at Margate, Sean Duffy and Mike McGrath, the perennial favorites who have won several races and been crowned champions many times, as you know, being their chief. But you got to watch out for Seattle City's Danny Rogers and Pat Scannapiccio, because these guys have been, they're right there in the mix.
Absolutely, and they pulled out a second in the Cape May Counties this year. They pulled out a second in the Bench and Callahan's, and they won at the Kerr Memorial. So they're definitely a fan favorite tonight and definitely have a shot at the title.
Wildwood Crest has a young crew. Pat Bakey and Jake Klecko. You know the name Klecko. That's
I do.
Famous football name, right?
Yeah.
he came. They came in. I believe they came in second or third in the Kerr Memorials this year. And I got to tell you, they're a crew to watch. They're a doubles crew to watch.
You know, it takes years to really, I would say, to conquer the art of rowing. It's not like rowing a cruise shell. Then you have the waves, the surf, the way that the tide is going that night. Lots of factors. The more you race, the better you get. And these guys are getting better because they're racing a lot more.
And you know what, Dan? That just feed off of what Jack just said. Experience. How many times have we talked about experience? Like any other sport, football, basketball, whatever, professional, same thing applies to here at the boat races.
Absolutely. And that showed, you know, through and shined through for Longport in the Atlantic City Classic. They're effort and their being together for so many years made it so easy for them, and they just rode a really good race that night. But you're talking about crews. Those top three crews in that race were on top of each other. You had Mike McGrath, Sean Duffy winning it. You had the Savelle brothers getting second place, who were right just behind them. And the Savelle brothers won the Longport Memorials. And then you can't count out, you know, Hayden Smallwood and Bob Bechtel have come a long way from that first race in Longport to the AC Classic, and they're going to give it a run for the money tonight as well.
And Jack, you know, Mother Nature throws a monkey wrench into these races. You know, when I was at the Bastion Callahan's a couple weeks ago in North Wildwood, Dennis Makey, Tom Lake from Stone Harbor catch an outside break, Jack, and they take it, they blow right by everybody to win the race.
Been known to have a lucky win before. There was actually one young man that actually created a company called Wave One, because he came out of nowhere and won on a wave. Singles, and singles is the cruelest sport. I was a singles rower, as you well know, and boy, anything can happen in that race.
But that was the same thing, and I missed it on here, but the Ocean City rower that came back was in like seventh place at the AC Classic, and he came back,
Taylor Smith,
and he came back and won that race based on a wave and catching it on the outside.
I've met that young man, Dan, and I'll tell you, he's the kind of kid that really wants to learn, open-minded, listening to everybody and input, but more importantly than anything, he's getting out and getting after it every day. He wants to be the guy.
I got to tell you, guys, we stirred the pot a little bit because the Wildwood Crest crew rode really well, and Danny Nagel from Brigantine was not a happy rower. He was beaten by his own teammate. He was beaten by his own teammate in the race. His name eludes me, but he was not happy all week. And when I got on my radio show for the Beach Patrol report, sponsored by McCann Realtors of Seattle City and the Ocean City Lifeguard Alumni Association, I stirred the pot a little bit, Jack.
You know, that's not the first time long-time listeners will say you stirred the pot. Let's face it.
Billy,
good competition.
We're looking at this, and we talked about it a little bit pre-race. We're guessing, just looking on the distance of the doubles, we're guessing it's going to be about a 12, 13-minute race, which is a little shy of the South Jerseys. But, you know, when you look at the races that they've had so far this year, the only two that have been 15 minutes plus were the Longport Memorials and the AC Classic. The Bench and Callahan's, the doubles row, was only like four minutes, 11 seconds was the winning champion, you know, in that race. So it's a whole different element, and this is going to be a chance tonight. And with this heat and the factor, there is a nice little southerly wind blowing here. It could be anybody's race tonight, I'm telling you. It's wide open.
Dan, I agree, Dan. I think the heat's going to be a bit of a factor tonight because it is sweltering out here, and it's really going to kick the long races, especially the doubles.
Does the water temperature come into play, Jack Brooks?
You know, as a swimmer, too, longtime swimmers will tell you they like a cooler water because they're humping it. They're going to sweat. They're going to pour it out. You know, if the water temperature is too hot, it kind of saps your strength a little bit. So I think they're going to be going at it. I don't think it'll affect the swimmers. Rowers in this heat.
That water temperature, though, tonight, just feeling it just before the race, I'm guessing it's in the high 70s.
All right, guys, we're looking forward to a great race as we build up to the start of the race, which will be at 6:30 tonight. We're obviously, this is our pre-game, pre-race part of the broadcast. I want to remind people that 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships are brought to you by Blitz's Market, voted best deli in Ocean City 7 years running. Blitz's now has online ordering at blitzesmarket.com or give them a call at 609-399-9983. Try their famous breakfast sandwiches or delicious hoagies. And also, now they're having freshly squeezed orange juice available. That's Blitz's Markets in Ocean City, New Jersey. And by McCann Realtors of Seattle City, family-owned since 1939, experience the McCann difference. Located at 4111 Lantis Avenue in Seattle City, it's your one-stop shopping for sales, rentals, investments, mortgage lending, and appraisals. 609-263-7422. And by Surfer Supplies of Ocean City, serving up Stokes since 1962. Stop by Saturday for their one-day Night in Venice sale. 25 to 50% off all summer wear for the entire family. Surfer Supplies now has 250 new surfboards in stock, plus their 2023 fall gear has arrived. That's Surfer Supplies, 609-399-8399, or go online at surfersupplies.com. All right, you're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races. We'll be back right after this.
You haven't downloaded the 97.3 ESPN free mobile app? Well, go get it now to follow all the Philly sports teams at 97.3ESPN.com, powered by First Bank of Sea Isle City.
All right, we're back here broadcasting live from Wildwood tonight at the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships. 97.3 ESPN's live coverage is brought to you by All Campus Sports Headgear, 1028 Boardwalk at Ocean City, with over 500 college and professional sports teams hats in stock now. You're guaranteed to find your team's hat. Give them a call, 609-778-7266. And I got to tell you guys, as we get ready for the race, we're at the north end of the race, Jack Brooks. All the racers, we're at lane one, looking south. Who has the advantage? Would you say in the races, what lane would you say has the advantage?
I would say if you're in the middle, then you have the best odds. But it doesn't always work that way. Some of the beaches have advantages up in one lane or the other, you know, and it just doesn't really make sense sometimes. I will say the women's tournament in Ocean City, you know, lane one had plenty of winning races, but so did lane seven and eight.
I can tell you this, Billy, speaking historically from this race, it always seemed like the southern lanes did better here in Wildwood.
And that's just my opinion. I'm looking here at the flags, guys. We got like an onshore breeze pretty much. That shouldn't have any effect on the race.
Nah, you know what? These are all seasoned veterans. These are seasoned rowers. Yeah, some of them are younger crews that have been rowing for the last 2 years. But, hey, these guys have been training all year. The conditions out here tonight are not going to affect any of the rowers, that's for sure.
And, guys, right now I'm gonna welcome up to the booth, if you will, a former Wildwood Beach Patroller, and her father is a great sponsor of the locker room, the Beach Patrol Report, and all the races throughout the season. The Dutch Hoffmans will be broadcasting live at the Margate Memorials. And, of course, we'll finish up with the South Jersey Lifeguard Championship. Let's welcome in Myra McCann. Good afternoon. Good evening, Myra.
Good evening. I'm so happy to be here.
Myra, this is your stomping grounds, right? You were 8 years on the Beach Patrol.
8 years.
What was your fondest memory of working here in Wildwood?
Oh, that's a tough one. Wildwood beaches are probably my favorite place in the world. I mean, there's nothing like them. I grew up in Ocean City, and everybody always thinks it's so silly that I guarded in Wildwood, but I wouldn't have changed a thing. My dad brought me down to Wildwood with his history down here, and it's a one-of-a-kind place and the best place in the world, I think.
Well, speaking of history, the McCann family is synonymous with Beach Patrol racing here in South Jersey. Your father was the chief down here for many years.
Yes, 11 years. And I actually was, when I was born, I am in a lot of the Beach Patrol seasonal pictures. So I really went back to my roots when I came down to Wildwood to work.
You know, Billy, I got to interject there because it was great, you know, being a family guy in Lawport, you know, following my uncle's footsteps. And then my kids, all three of my kids following my footsteps and being guards in Lawport, my daughter Katie, my daughter Megan, my son Daniel. It's a great feeling and a great pride to be a part of a family history and tradition in lifeguarding. And for those of you out there that have never been a lifeguard, this is the greatest job in the world.
Absolutely.
If you have an opportunity, go out for a beach patrol and become part of this. It's something that you'll have friendships that'll last forever.
And of course, Myra, your Uncle Tom McCann, was in Sea Isle for many years.
He was, yes.
And right now they're doing the national anthem, so we'll try to keep it down. But what a very, very competitive family and beach-oriented. I mean, you guys are synonymous with racing, and if it wasn't for the McCann family, we wouldn't be broadcasting live here. So we want to thank you and your father and Uncle Tom for supporting the Beach Patrol Report with me on 97.3 ESPN through the summer on 97.3 ESPN, but also broadcasting these races. Your family has continued to participate.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. And on behalf of my dad, thank you. Like you said, the family that we have competing, we were competitive within our own beaches that we were in. My brother was a guard in Ocean City. I was a guard in Wildwood. I had cousins all throughout South Jersey. Racing day, it was game time, and we were just as competitive with everybody else, if not probably more with ourselves.
Well, Myra, you stick around because we're going to put you to work tonight.
All right.
And we're going to tell your father that we're putting you to work. We're going to get you to interview some of the racers when they come in. You
sounds great. Yeah, all sounds right. Great.
Hey, speaking of competitive, thank you, Myra.
Yeah,
thank
really
you. It was
really
good having you in the booth. All right. Guys, speaking about competitiveness, I started the pot a little bit. We're talking about the youth movement here and some new blood with the racers from Cape May Point all the way up to Brigantine. Well, you know, your boy, Sean Duffy, he was on the radio.
I'm going to keep to my true blue colors in Longport. They're going to be in the hunt tonight. They're going to be in the top.
But
they're definitely
going to
be there.
The young guys from Sea Isle and Avalon, Sean Duffy even said he's 40 years old. It's not getting any easier for him.
It's not. And you know, they just speaking to them recently, they're actually training harder now in this year than they have any other year to get prepared for these races. And that's because of the age. The age does take a factor on your body. You don't recover. You don't heal as well. And this is a painful race. This doubles race is painful. And let me tell you, you say the wind might not be a factor, but it will be a factor to the point that some of the, you know, arms will be blowing up by the end of this because they'll be pulling extra strokes on one side or the other on the way out one way and on the way in the other way. So they're going to definitely feel this and feel pain after this race.
And Jack, you said it earlier, one of our earlier shows as we lead up to these races, that it's free entertainment, but it's the best quality of athletic competition you can get. It's for free.
You know, we talk about age and everything else. This is a volunteer kind of racing situation. You're not paid to race by a beach patrol. You're paid to save lives by a beach patrol. This is what you do in your spare time. It's fun. It's exciting. And that's what we're going to see tonight.
All right, we're going to see a lot of it. All right, 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships is brought to you by Blitz's Market. Voted best deli in Ocean City 7 years running, Blitz's now has online ordering at blitzesmarkets.com or give them a call at 609-399-9983. Try their famous breakfast sandwich or delicious hoagies and their all-new freshly squeezed orange juice. That's Blitz's Market in Ocean City. We're getting ready for the beginning of the race, so we're going to take a timeout. You're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races. All right, we're back from broadcasting live here on the beach in Wildwood for 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races. The race, the doubles are about to start right here any moment now. It looks like Wildwood is to the north. And who's in lane 16?
Lanes are ready. The flag is up.
And they are getting ready to go.
There they go.
They're off.
Wow.
Let's look at it.
Okay. All right, looks like Brigantine has a nice start there in the middle, that's for sure. Let's see how they get out. Right now it's looking like Brigantine and Margate, but let's see Margate makes it over that wave.
Right now, Brigantine and Margate have had the best start so far.
Brigantine and Margate. Atlantic City's out good, the Blair brothers.
And McGrath and Duffy here on the lane three looking good.
Yeah, they are.
You know, they're off to a good start. Let's see what happens here. Avalon looks good. They're in the middle as well. They had a good start, too. Brigantine still has a good lead right now. It's probably about a boat open water They're just passing through the surf as we go now.
Avalon, Gary Nagel, and Dave Julian.
But I'll tell you, Margate is right on their tail at this point in time. You know, they're pretty close. You know what? That's a dead heat right now looking at it from this angle.
Brigantine looks pretty good from here.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Brigantine and Margate are in like a dead heat right now the way it looks from the beach.
They're hitting that second break out there because there seems to be a little bit of a second break, Dan.
Yeah, this is definitely going to be a race winner, definitely a factor tonight. We're definitely going to see. But you know what? Hey, Wildwood looks good here on the end. Longport looks good in the middle there. This is anyone's race, like I said earlier.
So this is normally about a 17-minute race.
Normally it is, yes. And I think tonight's going to be every bit of that. It's going to really tax these people because it's a hot night out here.
See, I'm going to go against you guys. I'm going to say this race is going to be somewhere between 13 and 14-minute finish time.
All right, Dan.
We'll see what happens.
Okay.
But it's just my eyeball from here. You know, Billy, you know, you look at this field. Look how far spread out they are. It's this race is open right now. It's anybody's chance, anybody's opportunity to get a shot. And, you know, this field is open. I'm going right now. I think Margate might have passed Brigantine based on the angle that we're looking at right now.
All right, right now, let's welcome up into the booth Chief of the Wildwood Beach Patrol, Chief Steve Stocks. Steve, man, good to see you.
Hey, Billy, what a great night for racing.
This is awesome.
It's set up. It's ready to go. The doubles are out there. It's exciting. Here we go. All 15 of them out there.
Steve, this is a lot of work for you guys. You do a hell of a job.
It's a labor of love, man. You have a race. We have a big race, and then we have a big party. You know, it's kind of a summer celebration.
It sure is. And this is the first one of the big three. It's the first time all the beach patrols get together, and we see what we have.
Yeah, you know, you have the Cape May County crews battling it out down here and the Atlanta County up there. You know, in the beginning of the season, early season, getting it going, and now we all get here at the Hoffmans, and it'll be the Hoffmans, the Margates, and the Jerseys. But this is the first one where they get to see where everyone's at, match up together.
You know, and that's a good point. That's a good lead-in because you look at these crews. They're battling each other, but, you know, this is their first opportunity to see everybody together and get the playing field. It's a level playing field, even playing field tonight. They all have an opportunity. And, Steve, what do you think? Do you think there's a wave out there that could be a race winner?
Probably not tonight, man. I don't think there's anything on there. You just got to row, row, row. I mean, maybe you get a little bump, but I would just row on it. I wouldn't do anything other than row. These guys are big and strong. These waves are small. They can row as fast as these swells are going right now. You know, possibly a game changer is when you have 15 lanes. You know, it's a large course,
right?
You know, and you do your best to make it fair and make it even and balance it out. But when it can be unpredictable. You know, if you're doing 8 lanes, 7 lanes, 10 lanes, but man, when you get to 15
lanes,
and you're spreading that course out,
yeah.
You know, sometimes strange things happen.
Well, it looks like I mean, I don't see anybody really out that far in front, but they're getting out pretty far.
Brigantine,
Longport, Seville. There we go. And thank
okay.
God, thank we. I'm glad
fourth
we
was Wildwood
here.
Crest
he's
here too.
He's got his radio.
So I think they said Brigantine, Margate, Longport, Wildwood Crest.
Correct.
Look at the Brigantine crew, the Savelle brothers, Jack and Joe Savelle. It's fresh blood there, Chief Stock.
Yeah, I mean, that's not even halfway out, maybe just
right.
About halfway out. So there's a long
a
way to go.
A lot can change.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Steve, we talk about it, you know, being a lifeguard for 32 years and being in this race myself many times. It's all about being prepared. It's all about that start. It's all about the turn, and it's the finish. Keeping that boat straight, and like you said, humping on those waves. If it's not a race winner, don't jump back. Keep rowing, hump on the wave, and get that boat to the beach as quick as you can.
Yeah, these waves are not moving that fast, and these guys are so strong. Even at the end of the race, they know it's the end. They got the rate up. They're trying to end it. They're trying to finish it. They can row on these little things. I'd be very surprised to see anyone go back.
Well, we're going to watch that tonight. We're going to see how it plays out. But, you know, we've seen a lot of boats veer in smaller surf, and there is a little wave here. So I think it's going to be a factor on the cruise toward the finish. I think we're going to see some boats veer.
We have a nice crowd on the beach here checking it out. If you're in the area, I recommend you come on down to the beach right here on Lincoln Avenue, right in front of the Wildwood Beach Patrol headquarters here in Wildwood. Come on down. There's a big crowd. All the beach patrols from Brigantine to Cape May Point participate. And explain to us, Chief, about the meeting that you have before the race to determine what lane you're in.
Oh, so the competitors will draw. They'll do a blind draw to choose lanes. You know, like I said, you have 15 flags out there. You know, we've messed around with some different ideas. I really would like to consider seeding the teams.
Okay.
And having the teams that have shown speed, the doubles teams that have shown speed, be able to choose their lanes and then in order through the seedings. If you think about swimming in lanes, you think about crew races in lanes. The teams are seeded based on speed, based on performance. They like the middle of the course usually, and speed likes to be near speed. So if you could seed them, I've talked to a few chiefs about this idea. If you could come up with a seeding system for maybe the top five, top six, the fastest seeded crew picks their lane. The other crews may decide to be next to them, or they may decide they like another certain part of the course better. But they would have their choice of lanes. They could come down, they could see the course, they could pick their lanes. And then maybe the bottom 10 or the bottom 9, they do a blind draw. You know, if you want to be up where you're seated, then you need to show speed at some point in that season so you can get seated.
And also, I might add that this is the last race where you're more than just the singles, doubles, and the swim.
Correct.
I mean, you have also the female paddle, the male and female run, and the male paddle.
Right, so we do men paddle, men run, women run, and men swim, women swim. So I love to showcase our women athletes in South Jersey on the same night as the big event. I don't want to have a separate event for them. I want to have tremendous athletes on the Wildwood Beach Patrol and all of these beach patrols. They deserve, in my opinion, speaking for myself, they deserve to be a part of the big show, of the hometown show, of our big race, not a secondary race.
And I tell you what, it makes for a great race. Very entertaining stuff.
All right, so we just got an update at the turn.
Here we go.
We got Brigantine coming out first in the turn, followed by Margate, followed by Longport, followed by Atlantic City, followed by Sea Isle. So there's your five. We still got half the race to go. But
I was gonna say, it's still about, what, 9 more minutes before they come in? 8 minutes, baby?
Yeah, we're probably, I'm looking at the clock. I think I'm going to be pretty close on that 14-minute mark.
All right, Chief Stocks, I want to thank you so much.
Thank you, Billy.
Giving us access.
Hey, let me know if you need anything.
Set us up at the tower.
Sure.
Very, very great host.
Hey, we'd like to say that we're going to have a great race and we're going to have a great party afterwards. So you guys all come to the party,
all
right?
We'll be there. All right,
thank you.
Thanks, Steve.
Steve Stocks, Chief of the Wildwood Beach Patrol. As we wait for the racers to come in, and you heard it, what you said, Brigantine's in first.
Brigantine, Margate, Longport. Hey, look, it's four Atlantic County beaches in the top five going into this race. And Atlantic County, and that was part of that. You talked about you got that fire started.
Yeah.
You started talking. You got it fired. I think it fired some of these people up, and I think they're going to row hard tonight.
That's what we like, right, Jack?
They are rowing hard. I'll tell you, they are.
Jack, now, I know you're an old school guard, right? There's something to be said for all these races. You know, and I know, Dan, you're a former chief of the Longport Beach Patrol, Ocean City, Jack Brooks. How do you like all these events? Or would you like to see it whittled down to maybe four?
Well, I think you'll never get away from the big three at the end.
Right.
That's kind of the crescendo. I like the fact that they're featuring a lot of lifeguarding skills, running, rowing, swimming, paddling, you know, all those things. I mean, if we get to jet ski races, I guess that would be really fun to watch.
I don't think the insurance would ever let us, but anyway.
Probably not, but the idea is, you know, they have broadened it out. They do feature a lot of them. They have women-only races. They have co-educational races like today. Well, and I think that makes it exciting. I think Steve
and that's
is
a great that's
right.
a great point. And let me tell you, being the president, former president of the South Jersey Lifeguard Chiefs Association as well as being chief and on the beach for 32 years, they have tried to adapt and change the South Jerseys, but it has stayed a traditional race. And guess what? I'm one of those guys
that feels traditional. No.
That race needs to stay the same. That race is double, swim, singles. That's it. Well, hey, there's a separate paddleboard event in Brigantine, and they all get to showcase their paddleboard skills. They have relays, everything else. I'm all about it. You want to have another race? Feel free. But you can't touch the traditional three races in the South Jersey Championship.
Two changes they've made in the last 50 years of the big three. One is they added a singles, because originally it was just a doubles and a swim, so they added a singles race. The other was switching to fiberglass boats in the 1960s and 70s.
So we just had one little change and one little update. It's still Brigantine in first, followed by Margate, and Atlantic City just got an edge on Longport. So Atlantic City's in third, followed by Longport in fourth. Sea Isle in fifth, and Avalon in sixth is what they just gave us.
All right, the 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships are brought to you by McCann Realtors of Seattle City, family-owned since 1939, experience the McCann difference, located 4111 Landis Avenue in Seattle. It's your one-stop shopping for sales, rentals, investments, mortgage lending, and appraisal. 609-263-7422. And by Surface Supplies of Ocean City, serving up Stokes since 1962. Stop by this Saturday for their one-day Night in Venice sale. 25 to 50% off all summer wear for the entire family. Surface Supplies has 250 new surfboards in stock, plus the 2023 fall gear has arrived. Surface Supplies, 609-399-8399, or go online at surfacesupplies.com. Now, the guys are coming in.
Yeah.
It looks like everybody's being blown north, Dan.
Well, what they've done now is they're close enough to the shoreline that they've now turned and angled themselves with the waves. They're actually riding on the swells and angling themselves with the waves. Right now, it looks like Brigantine's got open water, about two boats,
I would say
followed by Margate, yeah. And then Atlantic City probably has a little edge on Longport, but Avalon just caught a little swell there. It's going to come down to the finish here, Billy. It's going to come down to what happens on these waves.
How about this, Jack Brooks? Brigantine. Two and a half, three boats in front of all these experienced guys on the beach patrol, these rowers.
Oh, Atlantic City's on a wave. Here we go. Here we go. What did I talk about earlier, Billy? Anything can happen, but again, they should stay in the seat and row that. They should have kept rowing that.
Look at Margate
too. Back on it.
Wow, this is going to be a photo finish, if I believe.
You know what it is.
Here comes Atlantic City again. This could be the difference right here.
This could be the difference right here. It's going to be the difference. As long as they keep that boat straight.
What a beautiful wave.
And Longport's got a wave
on
the outside.
Wait a second,
they're going to
approach. They got to keep it straight. It looks like Atlantic City has finished the race first.
Yeah, Atlantic City, Brigantine. Let's see what happens here, though, because
Brigantine second.
Sea Isle's on a little swell here. Margaret's going to cross.
Third.
But is Sea Isle going to edge out Longport?
Longport and Beard.
It's going to be fourth. It's going to be Sea Isle.
Rick
followed
and
by
Sean.
Sea Isle fourth, followed by Longport fifth. There's your points right there.
Wow.
And look at this. Look at this Vetter boat coming in. You got a young crew there in Eric Ruane. He's rowing with
That's a
his
beautiful
partner,
wave right there.
Anthony Merendino. Look, they rode that thing to the beach from the outside. Here we go. That was a beautiful wave, a beautiful finish. Hey, Eric Ruane, Chief Bergman's grandson, rowing
How
in the stern
that?
Tonight.
Wow.
Well, about history and tradition.
That's part of it, isn't it?
I got to tell you,
absolutely.
Rick and Sean Blair.
Unbelievable.
Atlantic City.
They're the defending South Jersey champions. They won the South Jersey championship in 2022.
Right.
They're a team to be reckoned with.
And then Atlantic City, Margate.
Atlantic City, Brigantine, Margate.
Right.
And then Sea Isle, Longport. So out of the top five, four are Atlantic County crews.
Well, Dan, that was an exciting race. And again, we talked about it earlier that the waves may be a factor, and they certainly proved they were at the very end there. If they had to stay on that wave, they had to keep that bow straight, and if you broach, it's over. You know, that's the big chips in the pie here. You got to watch out for broaching or turning or twisting. You got to have a perfect race on that wave.
Jack, you got to keep that boat.
Yeah, absolutely. And that was the difference between fourth and fifth place for Longport and Sea Isle. Sea Isle kept their boat straight coming in, and Longport broached and veered a little on that wave.
You got a 325-pound boat. And then you got the guys in the boat, and then I'll tell you, it's hard to handle on those waves. These are experienced crews. They really showed us something tonight.
Well, and think about the Blairs. Well, again, we talk about tradition. Boomer Blair, Atlantic City Beach Patrol. You talk about tradition. There's a name that's been around for a long time. And you know what? Hats off to them. They rode a great race tonight. Brigantine was out the whole way, but it comes down to the finish, and we talked about that. Start, turn, finish, and that's what it's all about.
Every one of these crews, Dan, are exhausted. I can just see it as they get out of the boat.
So let's recap. Looks like Atlantic City, the Rick and Sean Blair finished first. The Seville brothers, Jack and Joe from Brigantine in second. Third place was Hayden Smallwood and Bob Bechtel. Fourth place was Danny Rogers and Pat Scanapicio. And fifth place was Duffy and McGrath from Longport. Wow, what a great race.
You know, there's four of the five crews are from Atlantic County. I'm telling you, Atlantic County has been a powerhouse in the rowing side of things for many years. and they still contend and still show that.
All right, what race is next? I believe we have the female paddle would be next.
That's correct, and from what I've heard, they're going to start the female paddle
and then,
start the male swim at the same time.
All right, let's do some business here. 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the 53rd Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races are brought to you by All Campus Sports Headgear, 1028 Boardwalk in Ocean City, with over 500 college and professional sports teams hats in stock. Guaranteed, you are guaranteed to find your team's hat. 609-778-7266. All right, when we return, we'll continue with more here live from the beach in Wildwood for the 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Race.
South Jersey's play-by-play home for the Eagles,
touchdown!
Sixers,
oh yeah!
And Flyers.
He scored!
97.3 ESPN, WENJ, WENJ HD Millville, Atlantic City, a Town Square media station.
All right, welcome back to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races, live on the beach here in Wildwood on a beautiful, beautiful Friday night. I can't think of a better spot to be. Jack Brooks with and Dan Adams with me here calling the race. Dan, what do we got, Jack? We got the paddleboard start?
The paddleboard start, and we're in a tower about 20 feet off the sand. The women's paddleboard just started. Now, that's one competitor, a female paddler, will start out. It's going to be a box course. They go out, then they paddle to the north, then they paddle straight into the beach, and then they finish in the middle. This is going to be an exciting race as the ladies knocking it out on the paddleboards.
And they're actually getting hit down there by some waves. A couple boards got turned around. So they're definitely taking the brunt of it down there on the south side. There's definitely some big waves they're getting caught in. But it looks like someone's out. And I'm going to guess, if I'm a betting man, that's Grace Emick from Brigantine.
Now this
she did well in the Cape May Women's Challenge on Wednesday.
Yeah, absolutely. These people, once they start racing, they're racing.
And she just out-edged Lexi Sander in the long court women's race in the paddle row there. So
they're going to be knocking head-to-head today, I can tell you.
Hey, yes. Guys, if I'm not mistaken, I'm going to say the waves have actually picked up since we've been on the air.
Well, yeah, the tide is dropping a little bit, so it's going to definitely get that sandbar is going to come into play in the factor, and it's definitely going to have a better break on the outside. So by the time we get to the singles race, you're going to have more consistent waves breaking on the outside, and it's definitely going to have a factor on the finish.
Now, we're about 500 yards to the north of where they started, so the finish is going to get close to us when they come back in.
Now, is this the finish to our south?
I believe it's right here between the two broadcast booths. We're up in the air about 20, 25 feet in the air. We got a great vantage point. You're absolutely right that these waves on the closer set of waves are going to really be challenging to some of these shorter races. The box course, they go out, they go over, paddle up, and then they come in. So waves are going to be a factor, even the sideways today, Dan.
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be a factor. And you can see they're coming in on a little angle. And, Billy, you brought that up. You know, you talked about it. You said it looked like they were all going a little toward the north.
Yeah,
the doubles crews. And what they get to a point when they pass the singles, and they get to a point where they feel comfortable. They will turn and go with the swells.
Let the swell take
them. And make it a little better. Absolutely.
You know, the wind is out of the south, so everything's blowing a little north. Not a lot.
It's a little angled swell coming at us on an angle from the south.
So let the current take. Is that what you're saying, Dan?
At a certain point, you want to have the best course and the straightest course you can, but at a certain point, you can make that move, and it actually helps your advantage rowing the boat and actually gets you in a little bit quicker.
Now, Jack, we're here on the beach broadcasting live. I know there are people back in Ocean City. People actually in California have called and said they're listening to the live broadcast. It makes them feel like they're here.
You know, lifeguard races are exciting. So to try to describe this for everybody, there's three floating diamonds that are out there. The first group has already passed the first diamond. They're now passing the second diamond, and you're starting to see a little distance between them, Dan.
You are, but you're actually seeing that the first two are actually getting tighter than they were on the way out to the buoy on the first side.
And now...
Go ahead, Jack.
Okay, they're quickly approaching the third buoy. The third buoy is where they're going to turn and head in home. And that's where everybody, it's the same angle that they all just caught the races in the doubles.
That's correct. And it's right there, and you can see the waves breaking on the outside right here. They're starting to form up just on the inside of that buoy, and it's going to be a great race.
Now, we're also, the male swim is going to start soon, too, as well, right, Jack? I mean,
males are lining up. They're going to try to keep the races moving tonight, and the men may start. So you may hear us do that. Now they're rounding.
The men did start swimming.
The men just started their swim.
They did start to swim.
By the way,
they're off.
Let's look at the perennial favorite in this race is Dolan Grisbaum from Avalon. He's been cleaning up the last couple years, guys.
He has, and that's for sure. But, you know, hey, you can't count Zach Vassar out. He's had a great season so far.
He won the long ports.
He won the long ports by a little over a minute. So
now the men are on the out, going out in the surf on the south end of the course. Coming in on the north end of the course, here's the wave factor. They've all passed that first diamond. It's anybody's races
now. We have two paddlers that are neck and neck, and all whoever catches the wave is going to win this race.
Well, here you go on a little swell here. Brigantine, Avalon, Wildwood Crest.
By the way,
Wildwood.
Dan and Jack, this is where surfing might come into play here. If you're an experienced surfer,
every one of these paddlers is a surfer as well. They just love the sport. They've loved it since they were little.
Well, you know, that reminds me, and it was in, you know, I was looking at some old, you know, archives from the Dutch Hoffmans, and do you remember the year that Joey Tepper did the paddle first?
He did it here.
Did the paddle first, won, and then got into the swim, and then won the swim. So here's a guy that never really paddled before, but had the strength
in
that.
Can you tell me who this is right here coming in?
I think
in
they
the
said
right
it was Brigantine. It was.
Look at this, see, Jack, Danny.
They're neck and neck. This is going to be a sprint for the finish line, and we're right
here at the
finish line.
I'll tell you what,
the
girl on the inside is probably going to win it because she's closer.
Look at this. Oh, this is going to be a photo finish.
Oh, wow.
This is a run.
And once again, it's going to be Grace Emig from Brigantine outlegging. Hey, did you see what she did on that angle in that run? She did that, and that's the same thing she did in Longport. She's a competitor, and that's what it's all about. And here's Avalon. Wildwood Crest second. Grace Emig from Brigantine first. Avalon Beach Patrol third.
Alyssa Sidoneri.
Katie Collins from Wildwood, fourth place. Wildwood Lieutenant.
So, Jack, all these points, you score points at the end. You don't necessarily have to win every race.
You don't. You have to show up in every race.
You have to show up in every race.
You have to score points in every race.
And our final competitor getting fifth place was Ocean City, Mia Gallagher.
How about that?
Got the fifth place.
Well, let me go over the scoring just a minute here, Billy. As I said, scoring for first place, they win 5 points. Second place, 4. Third place, 3. Fourth place, 2. Fifth place, 1. So you can see how the scoring is done. But if you win a race and get 5 points, you're really, you know, that
you're,
matters.
You're in the driver's seat. Well, I tell you, that was a very exciting race. The female paddle was excellent and very competitive.
The paddle
photo finish, Jack.
The paddle turned into a running race at the end, and that was exactly
But Jack, that's part of the rescue, right?
It's fantastic. It's exactly these skills.
They're tools. This is what they use.
This is what they use every day in lifeguarding. You got to go out and paddle to get a victim. You got to go running down the beaches, and you got to swim for a victim.
Hey, we still have a couple competitors coming in the women's race, but the male swim or the men's swim has just made the final turn around the buoy, and it's a close race.
So,
there's nobody out far.
Dan, this is different. This is different than what we're going to see in the Margates and the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships, where they go out to a flag and come back. Now it's more like a box.
Yeah, you know,
Billy, Dolan Grisbaum, he looks like he's in a race here.
It's a close race. You know, whoever's winning is out by a little bit, but there's six swimmers that are right there pretty close.
They are
in a very close race here.
I know they can see each other. They're out there.
They can feel each other.
They feel each other. It's not just about flat-out speed. Some of this is psychology.
Here's the biggest factor when you look at this course versus the straight out and in. This is more spectator-friendly, and that's what this race is all about down here in Wildwood. They try and make this a spectator event. You see what the whole event that they put on here, the whole show, it's all about the spectators. It's all about getting people involved with lifeguarding and showing them what lifeguarding's all about. And the more you can see, the better you're going to feel about it, and the more you're going to love the thought of being a lifeguard.
As the males come in, they're about 100 yards offshore, and this looks like a pretty close race, Jack. I mean, you got one guy would probably be, if I was a betting man, I'd probably say Dolan Grisbaum. But after that, there's 3-4 guys all lumped together.
If my eyes don't deceive me, we're starting to see a set build, too. And I think a set of waves is going to come just as they're finishing in, and that can change the race quite a bit, as we've already seen in the first two races.
Well, you think about it. You got Dolan Grisbaum, you got Zach Vassar, You got Jack Christian from Seattle. You got Brendan Lewis from Wildwood. I mean, you got some good Andrew Taylor from Seattle. You got some good competitors out there.
The leader's got a win.
Haney from Brigantine, another tough competitor.
These guys are swimming hard.
They are swimming hard.
And look, here's a wave right here, Jack.
Yep, and they're getting pushed slightly to the north. So, again, the straightest, somebody's going to have to run here. They're all going to have to run because where they're finishing is a little north.
All right, well, here's
the
wave. It could make a difference. Somebody on the outside caught the wave completely. He just passed the other two guys. But he's going to have to run
Grisbaum
a longer
looks
distance.
Like, I think Grisbaum's right in front of us, and he's still swimming.
And I'm going to say that.
Who is this? No, that's Grisbaum.
Grisbaum's there.
North. It's a running
race.
They're
running.
And that
Grisbaum.
Looks like Zach Vassar right here.
Grisbaum, number one from Avalon.
Zach Vassar, number two from Margate. And AC pulling out a third. Wow. Who do we got there,
Avalon,
Billy?
Margate, and AC.
Charles Schwiner.
Charlie Schreiner.
Schreiner. How about that? Schwiner.
His dad, Schreiner. His dad was the State Police Marine Bureau guy that was well involved.
What an exciting race that was,
Schreiner pulls out a third. And who do we get for fourth? Did we get that?
Now, to describe these people, when you're looking at this, these guys are still going hard. Right. I mean, the finishers have finished. Now you got the other guys coming in. Nobody's giving it up.
Did I hear Ocean City fourth?
Ocean City fourth.
Brigantine fifth.
Brigantine another point for fifth.
James Haney fifth. Ocean City, Dylan DeWitt was fourth. We got Zach Vassar in second from Margate. And who did we say was third place? Was Atlantic City.
Atlantic City.
Charlie Schreiner.
Wow, that was a close, close finish. Those two races had that factor of needing to run at the end. Can you imagine? You've just been in a race. You were in that race for 880 yards. And then at the very end, it comes down to sprinting the last 50 yards.
I'll tell you what, we got a race on our hands here. Nobody's really dominating. We had Atlantic City looks like to be probably Jack in the driver's seat with a first place in the doubles, a second place in the swim, or third place in the swim. It's going to be close.
It's you know what? They just gave the update on the overall. Right now, Brigantine has the lead with 10 points, followed by Atlantic City with 8, followed by Avalon with 8, and Margate City with 7, and Wildwood Crest with 4. And why is the reason that Avalon or AC is ahead of Avalon? Because AC won the doubles row.
5 points right there.
Yeah,
right,
so that makes a difference.
You're listening to the 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the 53rd annual Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races live from the beach in Wildwood. We'll continue with more here right after this.
South Jersey's play-by-play home for the Eagles,
touchdown!
Sixers,
oh, yeah!
And Flyers.
He scored!
97.3 ESPN, WENJ, WENJ HD Millville, Atlantic City, a Town Square media station.
All right, welcome back as we're broadcasting live on the beach in Wildwood. 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships right here on the beach in Wildwood. And Dan Adams, Jack Brooks, we're getting ready for the run.
Yeah, and Billy, you talk about a lot of young faces. You look down there at these runners getting ready to start for the male portion of the run. There's a lot of young faces and a lot of new blood out here tonight running in this race.
Now, this is where Chief Stock talked about an extra event to keep, everybody involved in it. But we're not going to see this next week, Dan.
No, we're not. But remember, this was traditionally a two-mile run. They changed it to a one-mile run, and they added the female portion to have both.
Jack, they're running the women exactly about 15 seconds after the men go. So they're really both co-educational.
Well, let's see if any of the women pass the men then. That would be interesting.
So they're gonna all run at the same time or not?
15 seconds behind.
15 seconds difference.
So that would
and then they're gonna start. So to describe people, they're gonna start the race, they're gonna run to the north.
They're off.
And they're going out. They've got a lead motor vehicle on the beach. They're gonna go half a mile down, turn around, and run back.
And look at the interesting factor as the girls line up, the guys were the same. Some of the people running are wearing sneakers. Some are going barefoot.
Yeah, right.
So I guess it's a matter of how you feel on the beach and what feels good for you.
I would say half the girls are barefoot and half are with the sneakers
and
on.
And the guys with the same exact way. Yep.
The same mix.
about the same mix. They don't want those waterlogged sneakers. They may slow them down a little
bit. That's true, too, right,
Jack? Hard to run in water.
There goes the girls. They're off, but I have to laugh because I just saw two bystanders jump into the men's race and jump in and start running with the male competitors other end. The girls look like they're sticking together as a group, where the guys had a couple people break out from the front. The girls are running as a group right now, and maybe that's something, a factor, because the hardest leg is going to be for them when they make that turn at the first quarter mile. That next half mile is going to be into this wind. It's going to be the strongest for all of them.
And speaking of the wind, I've noticed in the last 3 to 5 minutes, the wind came off the ocean a little bit and has dropped the temperature. I bet the temperature's down about 10 degrees.
Oh, absolutely.
Every Saturday throughout the summer during the 97.3, the locker rooms, live coverage of the Beach Patrol. We do the Beach Patrol Report, sponsored by McCann Realtors of Seattle City and the Ocean City Lifeguard Alumni Association. Jack, you're the president of the Alumni Association. What are you guys doing this year to give yourself some visibility, if it will, for all the – I mean, let's face it. You guys provide a service over the years saving lives.
125 years for Ocean City, and that's our big anniversary this year. We've got a number of different events. We're part of the Ocean City Baby Parade. We've been part of the Ocean City Baby Parade for 113 of the 125 years. That's coming up on August the 10th. We have a flag raising. We've got a lecture on the history of surf rescue equipment in all the beaches. Here comes the finish of the men's.
Well, I don't think we're at the finish, are we? Is that a half mile? Is this the halfway?
The half mile mark.
Yeah. So you look at this crew, they're pretty much together. You got seven people grouped together, one by themselves, and then another group of five, and then the two in the back. They are definitely staying together, and it's good to see that.
You can hear the crowd cheering them on right here at the halfway mark.
And that's a big difference when it's a mile and 2 mile run. It's a whole different strategy.
And I will say this, guys, Avalon, their runner, Brandon Hunts, I heard he goes to Penn State and ran a sub 5 minute mile, so it was 4 something.
Yeah.
Guys,
That's fast. We'll see how we can do it on the beach.
But like you said, Dan, they're all packed together.
And look at these swells picking up too. It's definitely getting a little more swell. And where did I say was going to be the difference? The south side could be a big difference.
You're
and
right.
There we are. Look at that wave.
It looks
on
like
the
south
side
is breaking a little bit more than the north side.
Yeah.
Now here come the lady finishers. They're in the or not finishers,
well,
halfway
got,
mark.
You got Wildwood. Looks like just in a barely in a little bit lead. We'll try and get the arm name on Wildwood and Ocean City are neck and neck here.
That's Katie Collins Joyce.
Followed by Margate, Wildwood, Crest, Avalon, and I couldn't see the last one.
About a 10-yard differential from the lead pack to the second tier, and they're a long way to go still.
And Dan just mentioned, you just mentioned the wind's picking up. As we speak, that could have an effect on the race.
They're running absolutely into the wind now. So they ran the first quarter with the wind. They ran the next half of the race into the wind, and then they're going to finish with the wind at the end, the last quarter, and we're going to see it right here.
97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Race right here in Wildwood. We got a great crowd on hand, all the trucks of all the beach patrols lined up here, and all the beach patrols are well represented, Dan.
You know, Billy, and this is a great view. You look back and you see the piers and you see the action. And what a great day I had. I got down here early with my grandsons and got to go to, TJ and Tanner. We got to go to the water slides and had a great time. But here they come. Here comes your finishers.
This is the Avalon Superathlon champion that's coming in the first place.
Yeah, this guy's tough to beat.
So we got Avalon.
And I told you, this guy,
Kate May, Wildwood Crest, Vetner, and Kate May Point.
Brandon Hans is just tough to beat in the run. He won the Bash at Callahan's. He won the Kerr Memorial. He's tough.
And again, that's 5 points for them.
That's five points.
This is changing the stack of the race a little bit. These count, and so's the women's finish.
So, Dan, this first place finish in the run, what
it's
Jack
gonna have
just said,
a big factor
it's going to have a big factor
score
on the overall score.
And look at Vetner coming in on a wave here.
That's picturesque right there. There he goes, 509.
509
mile.
That is fast.
Is that fast?
On the beach, that's a fast score on the beach. And with this wind as a factor, it's definitely a fast time.
509 miles.
That's
my car doesn't go that fast.
Too bad. And if you wanted to get a new car.
We're watching the singles rowers out there participating in a little warm-up action. And we're watching them ride some nice waves, some nice swells coming in. And like you said, Dan and Jack, this could determine the outcome of a race if you catch a nice wave.
It can, and the women's are coming in right now. They're really pouring it on here at the end. They can see the finish line in sight. It's right to the right-hand side of our booth. Avalon in first place with the female competitor.
Looks like Avalon just got another 5 points, Dan. Avalon, Wildwood Crest.
Ocean City was fourth. Who was that third?
Ocean City followed by Wildwood. So this has been a fantastic run. I mean, I'm very impressed. When we talk about the lady athletes on the beach patrols, you know, to compete against the men to get a job to begin with, then they go out and they compete. These are top-tier athletes. And again, doesn't cost anything to come to any of the races tonight, next Friday night, and also the granddaddy of them all, the South Jersey Lifeguard Championship.
How about Ocean City Beach Patrol, Chloe Kerr?
There you go.
Personal friend of ours, Toby's daughter, finishes fourth for Ocean City.
Fantastic finish.
That's a fantastic finish.
It makes it exciting. If you know your town, you know your lifeguards, that's part of the cheering, isn't it, Dan?
You know, there was no brigantine in the top in either one of them. Avalon just took a big jump. They took 10-point jump. And are now with 18 points.
Wow.
So that's going to skew it for, obviously, the next two races.
That will.
I mean, you know, you got Atlantic City who wins the double with Rick and Sean Blair, but they don't place in the run.
And you still have coming up the male rescue board, the female swim race, and then you have the open singles row.
Singles row.
But a lot of events, a lot of points left on the table there.
You know, let's talk about this because going into the Margates and the South Jersey with the three events and the scoring being the same, 5-4, 3-2, 1, you could win two events and still lose the title.
And people have, Dan.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, it's heartbreaking when that happens.
You could win two events, Billy, and still lose the title in the Margates and the South Jersey.
Yes, that's true.
So you have to score. To win those titles, you have to score in all three events.
A deep team wins.
You know, and sometimes it's scrapping out a third or a fourth to make that 1 point difference, and that's all it takes.
The competitors know that, and that's why everybody finishes hard. There isn't anybody that kind of gives it up at the end. They know a lane change, a finish, a stumble at the finish line, any of those things are factors and wild cards.
You watch, the next 2 weeks, the winning score is going to be anywhere between 10 and 13 points for the overall team title.
All right, guys. 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships are brought to you by Blitz's Markets, voted best deli at Ocean City 7 years running. Blitz's now has online ordering at blitzesmarkets.com or give them a call at 609-399-9983. Try their famous breakfast sandwiches or their delicious hoagies and their freshly squeezed and orange juice. Now they got 12 ounces of pure liquid sunshine in a bottle. That's Blitz's Markets in Ocean City, and by McCann Realtors of Seattle City, family owned and operated since 1939. Experience the McCann difference, located 4111 Landis Avenue in Seattle. It's your one-stop shop for sales, rentals, investments, mortgage lending, and appraisals. 609-263-7422. That's 609-263-7422. And by Surfer Supplies of Ocean City, serving up Stokes since 1962. Stop by Saturday for their one-day Night in Venice sale, 25 to 50% off all summer wear for the entire family. Surfer Supplies has 250 new surfboards in stock, plus the 2023 fall gear has arrived. That's Surfer Supplies, 609-399-8399. Or go online at surfersupplies.com.
Billy, I'm going to interject since you just talked about your sponsor, Surfer Supplies, Andrew Funk.
Andrew Funk.
Part of the Surfer Supply family. Talk about a tradition in lifeguarding.
And
talk about a tradition
in rowing.
Hey, Ashton Funk would have the most team titles by anybody if he was still rowing
right
today. Dave Funk is right there, still rowing, still part of it.
And Andrew won his share.
And Andrew won his share. And Dennis. Dennis was South Jersey champion as well.
So the Funk brothers.
So you talk about about some genes, and you talk about genetics, and you talk about tradition, and you talk about history. There's a family with a lot of history and a lot of genetics when it comes to lifeguarding and rowing.
All right, there you are. 97.3 ESPN's live coverage will continue right after this.
You haven't downloaded the 97.3 ESPN free mobile app? Well, go get it now to follow all the Philly sports teams at 97.3ESPN.com, powered by First Bank of Sea Isle City.
All right, welcome back to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships, live from the beach in Wildwood. And right now we're in the middle of the men's paddle. But right now let's go to Dan Adams for an update on the score right now.
So, Billy, in the overall score, we got Avalon in first place with 18 points, followed by Wildwood Crest. I don't have their points, but they're in second place. Brigantine in third place with 10 points. Atlantic City in fourth place with 8, and Margate City in fifth with 7.
Isn't that something, Jack Brooks? Atlantic City gets the first of the doubles, and they've fallen right out.
They're swimmer place, so they did get some points there.
But,
you know, we just had an update from the paddle right before the middle of the course. You had Brigantine, Ventnor, Longport, and Cape May was the top four in the paddle going into the halfway point.
So, finish of the paddle.
Oh, and here we are. They got a wave.
Oh, look at that.
And there's some waves on the outside. Look at this on the outside here.
Wow, this is going to be another picturesque finish.
We're watching the men's finish of the 880.
Oh, here we go. Someone just caught a bomb.
And the waves are playing a factor here. The men are paddling in, but a wave caught one. Now it's catching another. This is going to be a game run to the finish line.
Dan, look, I mean, this could change the whole dynamic of the race.
There's four people on one wave.
Look at this.
This is coming down to surfing skills right
now. Oh, one of them bailed.
Second one bailed.
One
is coming all the way in on a wave, and he's going to be the one that's going to be able to run across the finish line.
Who is it? Who do we have?
Andrew Shaw from Ocean City in second place.
Andrew Shaw is coming in second place.
I think Brigantine in first.
Brigantine first.
Andrew Shaw, Ocean City, second.
And Wildwood.
Cape May and Wildwood. That's
wow. Andrew Shaw from Ocean City.
He's been tough this year.
Wow, what a race.
So what do we have? What'd you say there? Brigantine?
Ocean City.
Go ahead.
Wildwood.
Cape May, then Wildwood.
Cape May, Wildwood, Longport.
But here's the thing, guys. You said it, Jack. They had two guys fall off. They fell off their board. They got knocked off their board.
One wave.
Knocked three people off.
Two, three off.
Changed the whole dynamic of the race.
It absolutely did.
Andrew Shaw stayed straight, stayed on his board, comes in second.
I knew Andrew Shaw when he was a boogie boarder on my beach at 12 years old. I know the kid knows how to ride.
Right, and that's what we said earlier. Experience, being a surfer, being a boogie boarder, knowing the ocean. Andrew Shaw's been doing it since he's a kid. He gets second in this race.
And a lot of the beach patrols, you know, they will talk about, well, there's a lot of races. There's races all season. That gives people experience. And you don't have to put your number one crew in each and every week. Sometimes they're trying out the second, the third place folks, giving them a chance at race experience.
Wow, what a race. And we still have a few racers coming in as some of the singles crews are continuing to work out as, I believe, is that our next race? No, we have the
women's swim.
The female swim is next. They're already out in the water.
They're out in the water. They're about at the halfway mark of the course. They're passing the middle pylon. Now, again, this is a box course. You have a first triangle out in the water that they go out and around. Then, as Dan was explaining, these races run parallel to the beach, so you can see them swimming down the course. It's not just straight out, straight back in, and you really can't see them. This is really giving you a visual about people coming up, and you can see the moving positions. Now the lead pack is coming up to the third pylon. When they round that, they will be heading for home, and we're going to see another run to the finish line.
And what a difference. You look out today compared to 20 years ago, the technology. You see the drones flying, following the course on the outside. the cameras and all this here. Hey, the live radio broadcast. This was not something that didn't happen until 5 or 6 years ago, and now it's part of, you know, tradition, and it's going to hopefully keep part of tradition because it's a great event and a great thing to do.
I got to say, guys, this is a lot of fun for us as well to be up here participating and bringing the race to people that can't make it to the beach, because I know...
You know, when you have 2.5-old life...
I'm not trying to have you guys here to make me look good.
You know, let me interject this.
I was on board for 2 years.
We got to give the race director and race officials some kudos.
Yeah.
They're running 7 races tonight. They haven't missed a beat.
No.
These races are running on time. They're running perfect.
And things are happening. Let me say this. I do like the fact that one race starts, and then a few minutes later, another race starts
There's no
consolidate
downtime.
The race.
Even for us, there's no downtime.
Right.
We're calling a race. Finish. They're already halfway through another race. It's exciting that way, though. It really gives the crowd some enthusiasm, and they, you know, they're picking it up. I can see that.
Now, Jack, you remember the name Dave Smith. He used to row for Ocean City years ago. John Smith. And he says he listens to the show, and he listens to the Beach Patrol report. He also said he loves us, our broadcast, because he can't make it to the beach. He's in it, you know, he can't, I don't think he gets around as well. He's like 79 years old. He really appreciates this, and I'm glad we're able to do this for people that love the beach but can't make it.
You know, I think it's your dedication to really, how many other places will you hear a lifeguard report on Saturdays about what happened in racing, building to live events racing, and it gives people that are, you know, they can't make it to the beach anymore, or time they're working or something, they can turn on the radio, and really, we're trying to give them the best we can in the descriptions of the race.
All right, here we go, Dan. What do we have? We got a girl just...
We got two girls here. One's a little to
the
north.
Here's a
big
wave.
Here she goes.
If she catches this wave, she'll win.
She fell off, but she's still
close.
The
key is getting to where you can stand, and when you can stand, you can porpoise, and when you can porpoise, you can run. And that's the way this race is going to finish. We got one woman standing up. She's already running through the beach. Right to her south is another one that's coming out of the water. They're checking it out, and they're realizing there's a close race for third.
Look at this next wave coming in here, and that is a beautiful wave. She caught it, and she's on it.
Long court. Jordan Ricchetti, first place. Sea Isle, second. Mary Kate Leonard.
Wildwood Crest.
Adrian Bilello. Well, there's Avalon scoring again.
I'll tell you what, Avalon, they got a great crew, Dan. They got a good crew.
They're tough competitors.
Ocean City takes fifth in that one.
Let's talk about that a little bit, because Avalon, you know, Longport went on the run for the South Jersey Championships, Avalon had won a couple championships in between, and they were the champion from 2015, hosted the 16, and the Wolf family, another, you know, you want to talk about tradition and what the Wolf brothers have
Matt,
done with
who's
rowing.
Now the chief.
And Eric Eric is right there teaching these young guys how to row and what to do and make a team. And that's what they did. They bonded. They made a strong team, and they continue to put a strong team out there today.
Jack, I want to point out that even though the rest of the girls are coming in here, look, they're still like giving 100% on the way in. Nobody quits.
And that's what people can be assured of that are in the water. If you're in trouble, there is nobody going to quit on getting you back to the beach. So let the guards know. Listen to the lifeguards. Prevent a drowning. But boy, if you get into trouble, they're not going to quit on you.
I guess we're getting ready for the singles, which will be our last race of the evening. The singles rower, the boats are all lining up.
It's exciting. I can tell you that right now they kind of know the standing, and they're going to have to go out and race for the finish, and that's close in the top point categories. And, you know, Dan, you were talking about the rowers from Atlanta County, and now it seems like the runners and the swimmers from Cape May County. This is really a fine race to be able to blend Atlanta County, Cape May County, the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships here. We're seeing it in the Dutch Hoffmans. They're very competitive, and they all have different skills.
Oh, absolutely. And that just shows you how strong an athlete these lifeguards really are. You know, you look at them, they're swimmers, they're rowers, they're athletes, and that's what it is. A lifeguard is a true athlete.
What other job do you have to compete to get the job?
Right, to get the job. All right, let's preview the singles, our last race of the night. Guys, this is going to be real. This is going to be a great race. Jacksonville's doubling up from Brigantine.
Sean Blair's
doubling up. Smallwood from Margate's doubling up. McGrath is doubling up. Danny Rogers is doubling up. I believe Brandon Joyce, he's doubling up. So, Jack.
It was a hot race to begin with.
Mike Fitzpatrick from Cape May's doubling up.
We'll see what they mean is they rode the doubles. Now they're going to row the singles. And in that race, so how much gas is left in the tank?
How much gas is left
for
in the tank?
A singles rower?
Well, you know what? At this point in time, you know, I never rode two races like this. I either rode doubles or singles in my career when I, you know, the short little stint I had of rowing. But they're rowing this race on adrenaline and adrenaline alone. And you look, you know, the true competitor, he's going to go out there, and one of those people that doubled up is going to win this race tonight.
All right, Jack, let's have a little fun, Dan and Jack. Who do you like? Who do you like in the singles, Jack Brooks?
Well, I'm going to go with the home team.
You're
for me.
You're going to go Ocean City?
Taylor Smith has been showing me something. He may not win, but he's going to be in the hunt.
So if you're going to do that, I know Dan's going to do the same
thing.
Yeah,
you know what? It's
going
to be hard.
On me, Dan
I'm
Adams,
not necessarily changing
former
up.
Former chief of the Longport Beach Patrol.
Mike McGrath will be in there and be in the hunt, but I'm looking at this lineup in the middle, and I'm looking at the beaches in the middle. You know, you got Margate right in the middle. You got Vetner in the middle. You got Avalon in the middle. You got Brigantine smack in the middle where that lineup
Dan,
is.
Dan, I'm going to tell you who's going to win this race.
Go ahead.
Seattle City, Danny Rogers.
We'll see.
He's going to win this race.
They're in a good position.
You know what, Billy? Position. I'll stay with it. I'll stay strong. I'm going Mike McGrath.
Ah, you're going to go Mike
I'm
McGrath.
I'm going to go.
Jack Brooks is going to go Ocean City. I'm going to go Seattle City.
They're coming up, and they're getting the boats into position here. They're starting to move them to the water's edge. That's always the key for the start of the race. We have now had the course where it's laying down a little bit if you look at the
By
waves.
By the way, just look at the, I think we've, the cloud cover.
Low
we got
cloud
a little
cover.
Mist. We got a three-quarter moon. It's beautiful. We can see the moon out here.
Billy, do you remember our interview with Danny Rogers back in 2019 in Longport?
I mean, I still get chills thinking about that.
Yeah, I mean, he was 18 years old at that point in time?
And he came up here and rode
such a great race,
and that was
awesome.
Let me just jump on that point that Dan made. Experience, I mean, he was a young kid. Now he's 5 years into it, right?
Yeah.
5-6 years into it. And he won the Bash at Callahan, I believe it was. He's an experienced rower now, Jack.
You know, it's exciting to watch people develop. I think that's what makes college sports so great. You see these kids come in as freshmen. They move to their sophomore year.
Yeah.
Then they get a little playing time. They go into their junior and then their senior year. That's always exciting in college sports. We get a lot of collegiate athletes here. That's exactly the train that they're on. 1 year guard, 2 year guard, 3 year guard, 4 year guard.
Hey, guys, as we look south, isn't this the epitome of summer? Look at all those boats lined up at the water's edge. Look at all the people here in Wildwood. And I hope you're enjoying our live coverage of the 53rd annual Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races live from the beach in Wildwood. The singles race, which is the last race of the evening, is getting ready to start, and we will have the call right after this. Margate's in the middle. Jack Brooks likes Ocean City. Dan Adams, former chief of the Longport Beach Patrol, is going to stick with his guy, Mike McGrath.
But I'm going to throw dark horses
Give me a dark horse.
I'm going to give you Savelle, and I'm going to give you Smallwood.
I'll go with that, too. I think you're right
on
there.
And I can't count out Blair because he's right there in that hunt, right where the waves are. Go ahead.
Yeah. Ready for my dark horse? Jake Klecko from Wildwood Crest.
Ooh,
How about that one?
Yeah.
Because I've been watching him. How about Ryan Finnegan from Avalon?
Just look at this picture. Look at this view of looking at the 15 boats lined up down the beach, ready to go. This is just awesome. This is what it's all about. This is lifeguarding and what's the
All right,
part.
They're off.
Let's see who's going to get that good start tonight.
Well, Mike McGrath got a good start.
Avalon just got turned in the surf.
And Mike's got nothing in front of him, though. He's got no waves in front of him. He's going to get out clean. Ocean City just started rowing.
I think you got something there, Dan Adams. Mike McGrath.
You know, they're
clean.
Getting hit. Smallwood just got hit, so he's not going to have a chance here. Vetner and Margate just kind of collided.
Ocean City's out front.
There you go.
But there's Brigantine right there in it, and Avalon right
there
in the middle.
Danny Rogers at the end. We can hardly see the boats are so far down.
Danny Rogers is out right there on that end.
All right.
You know, he's doing well there.
All right, 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races Championships are brought to you by Blitz's Market, voted best deli in Ocean City 7 years running. Blitz's Markets now has online ordering at blitzesmarkets.com or give them a call at 609-399-9983. Try their famous breakfast sandwiches or delicious hoagies and their all-new freshly squeezed orange juice. That's Blitz's Markets in Ocean City. And by McCann Realtors of Sea Isle City, family-owned since 1939. Experience the McCann difference, located at 4111 Lannis Avenue in Sea Isle. It's your one-stop shopping for sales, rentals, investment mortgage, lending, and appraisal. 609-263-7422. All right, when we return, we'll have the call of the finish of the singles. You're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races.
The hunt for October continues on ESPN Radio.
Another home run for Baltimore here in the inning.
While the Baltimore Orioles have fought their way to the top of the AL East, the Yankees are right in the thick of the wild card race, and they go head-to-head in Baltimore this weekend.
Throw to the plate, and he's out of home.
The Yankees and Orioles. Coverage begins tomorrow at 6:30 Eastern and Sunday at 6 Eastern.
Listen to Major League Baseball on 97.3 ESPN.
Ask Sherwin-Williams during the Shades of Summer Sale, July 28th through August 7th, and get 35% off paints and stains with prices starting at $28.92. That means 35% off our most popular color family, blue. Psychologists have found it to be soothing and relaxing, which makes it especially great for bedrooms and bathrooms. And of course, get 35% off all of our other colors. Shop the sale online or visit your neighborhood Sherwin-Williams store. Retail sales only. Some exclusions apply. See store for details.
The seafood, extraordinary. The value, tremendous. The sunsets, on the house. Uri's Waterfront Restaurant is open for outdoor and indoor seating daily, featuring delicious seafood and tropical summer cocktails. Uri's is Wildwood's home to mouth-watering crabs, including snow crab, Dungeness, Southern King, and Maryland Blues. Next door to Uri's is the Boathouse Restaurant. Two outstanding restaurants at one big location at the foot of the bridge in Wildwood. Experience what the Jersey Shore is all about at Uri's and the Boathouse.
Are you retired or retiring soon? Do you know how much money you need to live comfortably? Retirement Planners of America is here for you. These may feel like scary times. Several economists are saying that a recession is imminent. So what do you do? Ancient wisdom says plans fail for lack of counsel, but with many advisors, they succeed. Would you like to have financial peace of mind? Here's how. Step 1. Find out the amount of money you'll need to retire. Step 2. Have an actionable plan to get there. Step 3. Make sure that plan is executed to take advantage of market gains, but protect you from market losses. We would like to give you a free, no-obligation consultation to help you do all three. We will help you discover your magic number and give you the roadmap to get there. Call now to schedule your free consultation. 800-508-6108. That's 800-508-6108. 800-508-6108. Don't wait. Call 800-508-6108.
All investments involve risk, including losses. Past performance does not guarantee future results.
And now Martha Stewart for Skechers.
When I make a dish or embark on a craft project, I always use the finest, most fabulous ingredients and materials. Which is why, when it comes to footwear, I love Skechers. Because Skechers is the comfort technology company and uses the most luxurious, innovative materials and designs to make wondrously comfortable footwear with all the fits and features like Arch Fit and Skechers' world-famous air-cooled memory foam. It's exactly the way I'd make shoes.
Find Skechers at a Skechers store, Skechers.com, or wherever stylish footwear is sold.
Why would someone looking for a mortgage at the Jersey Shore take a loan from a company in Detroit or North Carolina or some other far-off place? Online mortgages promise a lot but don't always deliver. First Bank of Sea Isle City knows the Jersey Shore. We are local lenders. We use local appraisers and provide in-house processing. We understand the unique obstacles of financing in Cape May County. Don't take a chance. Local banking is better. Let us guide you. First Bank of Sea Isle City.
Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
All right, welcome back to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships, live from the beach in Wildwood. And as we're waiting for the singles is races going on as we speak, I want to remind people, 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races is brought to you by All Campus Headgear. 1028 Boardwalk in Ocean City, with over 500 college and professional sports teams hats in stock. Guaranteed to find your team's hat. 609-778-7266. And by Surfer Supplies of Ocean City, serving up Stoke since 1962. Stop in this Saturday for their one-day night in Venice sale. 25 to 50% off all summer wear for the entire family. Surfer Supplies now has 250 new surfboards in stock, plus the 2023 fall gear has arrived. That's Surfer Supplies, 609-399-8399, or go online at surfersupplies.com. Jack Brooks, what do you got an update for us? Who was first at the flag?
Longport first, Ocean City second, Sea Isle third. A little bit of a change.
And look,
right now,
guess what, guys? Look where the boats are.
Well, we just had an update. Longport, Sea Isle, Ocean City, or Longport, Atlantic City, Sea Isle, Ocean City is the update right now.
And it looks like they're just going with the current.
Waves.
You got Mike McGrath. Wow, there's Danny Rogers from Sea Isle just catching an outer break. And, boy, is he motoring by everybody.
He went past everybody.
But he turned.
Wow, Mike McGrath's still up, though.
Mike McGrath, he's going to win it now with this wave.
You got to keep it straight.
Danny Rogers just catches another wave. Kate Meg does, too, but he broaches.
Atlantic City got one here in the center. We got another one on the outside.
This is really exciting stuff.
Whoa. Margate just really almost broke.
Looks like Longport's going to win this race.
I don't know. It's close. We got Atlantic City getting this wave.
Look at Atlantic City ride that wave in.
Wow, he just won the race.
He did.
Atlantic City out of nowhere.
Mike's not across yet.
Looks like Seattle. Mike's not across.
Mike's got across. He's across now, so second. Looks like Sea Isle's going to be third, followed probably by Kate May.
Well, that was an exciting race, Jack Brooks.
It's an exciting race, and you see that finish. The wave gods are either very good or very bad. It seems to me that that really changed the race, Dan.
It absolutely did. The wind picked up. The waves picked up. It started breaking on the outside. The tide dropped. But who was one of my dark horses?
Atlantic City.
Blair from Atlantic City.
And that's Sean Blair. He doubled up. He also rode doubles. But I got to tell you, Jack, was that picturesque? And was that, look, where did he turn the flag? Where did the Blair? He wasn't even in it.
No. You know, the exciting part about the singles race, and then you see the waves breaking here, and they just kind of picked up at the finish of that race. When you see those waves set up like that, you know some spots are going to change. And the experience of being able to keep that boat straight on the wave, not to go left or right or broach on that, that's going to make the difference in the race, and it did tonight with Atlantic City.
Wow, what an exceptional race. The singles, very exciting. Doubles was exciting tonight. It sets the stage for next week.
Next week in Margate, for
the Margate Memorials, Jack.
You won't see quite as many races. Next week it's only the doubles, the singles, and the swim. But tonight showcased racing and lifeguards
at its finest.
Well, let's recap real quick. Just in the singles, you had Sean Blair from Atlantic City finished first. Mike McGrath finished second from Longport. Danny Rogers third from Sea Isle. Mike Fitzpatrick fourth from Cape May.
Okay, there you go.
And your dark horse, Billy, fifth place, Jake Klecko from Wildwood Crest.
Jake Klecko, and he must have caught a wave because he wasn't even in the conversation on the way out.
And let's talk about what you just said. It's three races next week. Let's talk about that, because look at that swim finish.
Right.
That swim finish, Dolan Grisbaum was not winning the race and came back and out-sprinted Zach Vassar to get first. So there was a little change there tonight. Maybe his course was a little off tonight. He was a little to the north. I don't know. I think it's going to be anybody's race next week in Margate, and it's open.
Anybody's race, and that is a swim pack. They're going to be with the pack, and it's not just about pure speed. There's some psychology to it. But, boy, when you win – not by swimming, but by getting in shallow enough that you can run, that makes a difference.
But let's talk about that. Atlantic City finished first in the doubles, first in the singles, and third in the swim. Enough to win a title. That's enough to win the South Jerseys.
Dan, you got some calculating to do.
They have a shot there. There's no doubt that they have a shot.
You got some calculating to do, Dan Adams.
For those
that are looking on the sports book, Well, this race did not count for next week. It's going to be a close race, is what Dan says.
I am definitely saying that. And you think about it. The years that Longport was strong and finished in the title, they had a strong swimmer. You know, that first year.
Joey Tepper,
that
right?
First year, Joey, or first year, John Tepper. Down in Sea Isle in 2016. John came out of nowhere and got third place.
Jack, I got to let me just refresh your memory. If you weren't in Avalon in 2016, was it when you guys won your first?
That's correct, yeah.
Look, that gives me chills as well. I'll never forget the current was blowing heavy out of the south, blowing north. Tepper gets out of the water way
fifth
north.
Fifth place.
And he sprints. And you guys, every single person that was from Longport, whether we're on the beach patrol or just a spectator, was on the, like, jumping up and down. It was like somebody intercepted a ball, was running in for a touchdown. And Dan, I'll never forget it. And, you know, I'll never forget the emotion in your voice.
Absolutely.
And the emotion of Mike McGrath and Sean Duffy after they won. And it was just such a, what this is all about.
You know, yeah, and think about that. You know, John Tepper, how strong he was. He came back and won in 2017.
Yeah.
He won the title and took the swim title. But, you know, you got to remember, Billy, you were on Longport for a couple years. Yeah. LPBP, lowest paying beach patrol and last place beach patrol.
You know, Dan,
and that has changed over the years.
And you're too modest to say that, but I know you had a big impact there, and you had a big impact on racing in Longport.
You know what? It's all about the competitors. They were the ones that went out there each week and did it. I just afforded them the opportunity to make it happen and afforded them the chance to train and afforded them the chance to be true competitors and to go out there and win it. But, you know, hey, I was as chief, I had two titles. Matt Kelm had three titles. I mean, what a great thing we had there for, you know, that tenure that we had that run.
All right, 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships has been brought to you by Blitz's Market of Ocean City, McCann Reelers of Sea Isle City, Surfer Supplies of Ocean City, and, of course, Blitz's Markets. I want to thank our sponsors. Without them, Jack, we wouldn't be on the radio.
That's correct. You know, and I think every one of them has a connection to the Beach Patrol. They see lifeguards. They feed them some of these markets you're talking about in other places. You know, this is really one of the true things where people support their town, they support their lifeguards, and they support that history, tradition, culture, duty, and honor of saving people out of the sea.
All right, we're going to take a short break. Dan Adams is going to do some calculating, and when we get back, hopefully we'll have the winners for you and all the results of the race. You're listening to 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the 53rd annual Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races live right here on 97.3 ESPN. All right, we're back live here on the beach in Wildwood for 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the 53rd annual Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Championships from Wildwood, and what a great race. Dan and Jack Brooks here. Dan Adams, former chief of the Longport Beach Patrol. Jack Brooks, former lieutenant of the Ocean City Beach Patrol. We had a great night for racing, and I think, Dan Adams, you have an unofficial tally for the winners tonight.
That's correct. Unofficially, in fifth place, we have Sea Isle with 12 points. In fourth place, we have Atlantic City with 13. Wildwood Crest and Brigantine scored the same. If they're going with the tiebreaker, Wild Crest will be third, Brigantine will be second because
that?
They finished higher in the doubles with 15, and Avalon wins the overall event with 20 points.
Look at Dolan Grisbaum, the swimmer, in a close competitive swim tonight, Jack. That was the difference between winning the race and losing the whole competition.
It always comes down to one race, and you don't know which one. When you have eight events, you didn't know which one was going to jockey, but everybody was in the position. It was just somebody's race to lose.
But it definitely helped that the runner came in first, won that event. And then I think their female runner actually finished in the top three. But I'm going to go back to the singles race because we sat up here and we joked about our dark horses. We joked about who would finish. I got to say, the only one that didn't get a top five finish was Jack Sky, but that's okay. You know, Billy, we got a top five finish, and we got a dark horse that finished
just
in the top five.
That's because we're veterans of the broadcast. Jack, I want to say this. Ocean City Taylor Smith, he not only broached in the water, he lost an oar. And he was, once you lose an oar, you're dead in the water.
But he was second at the turn. But here's the thing. First year he's been rowing singles
right
with Ocean City, and he's shown up in a couple of different races. But, you know, I can tell you one thing. That kid tomorrow will start go through what the mistakes were and correct
them. And let me expand on that. I beat you 32nd Street, and I watched this young man work out, and he works out hard. He's out there rowing every day, Jack, and you know, Dan, just as well as Jack does, you got to put the time in. And if you don't put the time in, you don't get the results.
I've often said with Dan, you know, Dan, the crews that row first thing in the morning are not using the same advantages of the crews that row late
at
in
night,
the evening.
Yeah.
The race doesn't happen at 7 in the morning or 8
in
the morning.
Not.
The race happens at 6 or 7 or 8 at night, and that makes all the difference in the world. That was the experience.
You know what,
on
I'm going to tell him that, Jack.
But think about it. You take this race tonight, and you just have three events in it. The doubles, the swim, the singles. Atlantic City walks away as the team champion.
All right, guys, let's talk about next week because we'll be back at it again next week, only we'll have the addition of John McShane's knowledge with us. We'll have four of us up in the stand. Dan, I'm going to start with you. With just the three events in the Margates and the South Jersey Lifeguard Championships, who's the odds on favorite? Who do you like?
Well, right now, tonight, after tonight's finish, you got to go with Atlantic City.
Atlantic City.
They had two first-place finishes in the doubles and in the singles. The Blair brothers and Sean Blair finished first in the singles.
The singles.
And then, you know, you got Schreiner, who is his – this is like his first race. Now, I don't know – you know, it's questionable on – I'm not going to get into eligibility – but you don't know what they did prior to the season.
Right.
We don't know. I mean, there was something written about Dolan Grisbaum on the paper.
But I spoke with him off the air last week, and he's going to have it by 2 days.
But I know this for a fact.
That's official.
Zach Vassar has not missed a day, and he will be there. So that's going to be a factor. And, you know, hey, the start of the singles, I don't know if you saw it, but Margate and Vetner caught together.
Yep.
Hayden Smallwood took a little water. You know, but he still finished strong, almost flipped out here, but he still finished strong and came back. So.
Jack, there's no indication. Today's race really isn't an indication of what we might see for the simple reason Mother Nature could play a factor. You know, it could be a calm, it could be flat as a bay.
It could.
Or it could be gigantic outside.
Which there is a storm out in the middle of the Atlantic, you know.
That's absolutely right. You know, waves, the wind, I mean, that's what makes this type of racing so exciting. Is you don't know what the conditions will be on the night that you are going to be racing. The other is, we're down in Wildwood. All the way up to the north is Absecon Island. Now, the home teams in Absecon Island, there's something about when you're racing in Absecon Island, Margate, Ventnor, Longport, Atlantic City, those folks know how to handle the waves and the surf conditions in Absecon Island. And that makes a big difference. It's almost like a home field advantage.
You know,
let me ask you this, Dan, let me interrupt you. I was very impressed with the Blair brothers today. They didn't really show us that much in the Longports this year. I mean, I don't know if they rode together in one of the two races, and all of a sudden they come down here to Wildwood and they win the double, win the singles.
But don't be surprised. There's still row-offs to happen this week before the Margate Memorials in a lot of those towns. I know Atlantic City still has a row-off to happen for doubles and singles. I think Longport still has a row-off. I think Margate still has a row-off. Ventnor still has a row-off. So these guys still are not definite for next week. So the could be different next week.
I was shocked at Avalon. I thought Avalon would have a better showing tonight. It's racing, Jack.
Well, you go back to the depth of a beach patrol. Some of these patrols have over 100 some guards. Some don't have that many guards. So what you have is the mix of the competitors that go to that beach patrol. They work on that beach patrol. You have some that are very deep, and then some that really show up with the people that are there.
Well, you know, that's a good point, because you look at the Ventnor, Margate, and Longport beach patrols, you're looking at about 60 lifeguards on those beaches. Each beach has about 60 lifeguards. But, you know, one other factor I want to say about the distance of the singles tonight and the doubles, you're probably going to see the doubles in Margate a minute longer than what you saw tonight. You're going to see the singles at least a minute shorter.
And the swim is going to be one flag out and back, not the box.
The swim's going to be one, and that's going to be all about course. And Dylan Grisbaum's course was off.
Yeah.
And it was a box course. So that could be a factor come Friday night.
Well, guys, I want to thank you, Jack Brooks.
It's been great.
We had a lot of fun today. Dan Adams, as always, you do a great job. You guys are really add a lot of color to the race, and I really appreciate it. I want to thank our producer, Without him, we wouldn't be on. Danny Ryan.
Danny did a great job, too. Right under the wire, man.
I want to thank Josh Hennick back at the studio. Without either one of these two guys, we wouldn't be on the air. And they do a great job. Thank you, Danny. Also, want to thank Surface Supplies, Blitz's Markets, McCann Realtors, and All Campus on the Boardwalk for producing and sponsoring the race. And without them, we wouldn't be on the air. So thank you to them.
You have to have the sponsors, and you do. Isn't there a little radio program tomorrow?
Yeah, there is a program tomorrow. We're going to have the Beach Patrol Report.
Oh, will
we'll,
you?
We'll have interviews with all the racers. Myra McCann did a great job. She was on. She was down there interviewing the finishers, and we'll play all that tomorrow on the
show. You know, and that's something that's good about the Margates and the South Jerseys is we'll get those first-place finishers up in the booth during the race. Since there's only three races, we have time,
but in all fairness, we're far away from the
tent. Oh, absolutely.
We're like a country mile.
But, well, Bill, I got to give a shout-out to my wife for allowing me to come down here. You know, my wife, Susie, allowed me to come down
Jack
and be a part of this.
Bring his significant
and,
other.
You know, I wouldn't be able to do this without you, and I have a great time. And Billy, hats off for you for what you've done for South Jersey lifeguarding, putting it on the map, putting it on, you know, your show every week.
Absolutely.
From Memorial Day weekend through the end of Labor Day. You know, you each week and every week you talk about lifeguarding and you bring it to the table. And that's what it's all about. And you know what? These races are great, but you got to give kudos to all these lifeguards for the lives that they save and the differences they make each day out.
Absolutely.
So thank you and a great show,
guys. All
right,
guys. Well, we'll be at it this time next week. We'll be at it again at the Margate Memorials on 97.3 ESPN. Race time is 6. We'll be on the air from 6 to 8. Race time's at 6:30, and it's just the big...
Look for the elephant.
Right.
We'll be right there.
Which elephant, Jack?
Lucy it is.
All right, this will conclude 97.3 ESPN's live coverage of the 53rd annual Dutch Hoffman Memorial Lifeguard Races live from the beach in Wildwood. I will see you tomorrow in the locker room with Billy Schweim on 97.3 ESPN. Good night, everybody.